Please subscribe our channel Fajr TV to watch more that kind of videos.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Today we will discuss about Afghanistan. What is the background of Afghanistan? What are the surrounding countries of Afghanistan? And what is the importance, strategical importance, all things today about Afghanistan. First of all, the capital name of Afghanistan is Kabul, and the highest point of Afghanistan is Noshik. This is the part adjacent with Pakistan. This is almost in Chitral. So this is the point that is highest point. Its name is Noshik. And in the left side, in the western side, there is Turkmenistan, Uzbekistan, and Tajikistan. Northern side, there is China. This is Wuhan corridor, which adjacent to the boundary of China, Wuhan corridor. And this is the whole of Pakistan. This is eastern side, and this is called Durand line, very important line. And this is almost southern side. There is Iran. So this is, there is also another important thing, that is Amu Darya. This is the biggest darya, biggest river in this region, Amu Darya. Its English name is Oxus River. Its length is 2400 kilometer. So it drains its water into the Aral Sea. Aral Sea, that is the part almost Turkmenistan and then Kazakhstan. So its water goes to Aral Sea. So this is the history of Afghanistan, start from Paleolithic age, when Alexander the Great came here. He conquered the whole this region, and then the founder of Afghanistan is considered Ahmad Shah Abdali. Ahmad Shah Abdali, almost in the 18th century, 1727, almost its ruling start in Afghanistan, and he is considered as a founder of Afghanistan. He was also the founder of Durrani Empire. In that time, Durrani Empire was there. Ahmad Shah Abdali was the founder of Durrani Empire. So its international name is Islamic Republic of Afghanistan. Islamic Republic of Afghanistan, and it is landlocked country. There is no sea or ocean surrounding it. So this is landlocked country, and its anthem name is Mili Surud. And it remained buffer state between USSR. Abbreviation of USSR is Union of Soviet Socialist Republic. So Union of Soviet Socialist Republic, and between British. There was the government of British at that time. So this was in Great Game era. This was a buffer state, or we may say buffer state, that is the neutral zone. There was no one wanted to capture this region, although British has taken into its capture this region for almost 70 years. Like in first Anglo-Afghan war, this happened 1800, almost 42, this happened for 3 years. This war remained, and this happened. So British captured this region, this Afghanistan, and then second Anglo-Afghan war happened 1880. Then third Anglo-Afghan war took place. This war, 19 August 1919, Afghanistan took its land from the British. And this is right now, this 19 August, this is the reason that this is their national day and their victory day. 19 August is their national day and victory day. So this is some background of Afghanistan. Then there is, after 19 August 1919, Amanullah Khan came here and he imposed here monarchy. Monarchy, a system of government ruled by a king or queen. So Amanullah Khan became a king here, and he ruled here for 50 years. In Afghanistan, he ruled here for 50 years. Then from 1978 to 1988, communist government from USSR captured here, attacked here, and this was the attack to capture this region and to impose here communist government. Like there was in the whole region, this was USSR captured, like Turkmenistan, Uzbekistan, and Tajikistan. After this attack, USA came here and he supports to the Taliban, and directly war start between Taliban and USSR. And ultimately, in 1988, Taliban got victory over the USSR, and USSR was defeated. So then Taliban built here their own government. So almost their government starts in the time when there was Geneva Agreement, April 4, 1988. After Geneva Agreement, so USSR came back and the whole his army started to go back. So and this Afghanistan land became fully empty from any kind of external affairs, external intervention. So then Taliban almost started their government in 1994 from Kandahar. Their capital was Kandahar because Kabul was in the Ahmad Shah Massoud tribe. So the Kandahar, they chose Kandahar as their capital. And then there was refugees. When there was USSR attack, there was refugees. 3 lakh refugees came to Pakistan and 7 lakh refugees went to Iran. And Iran managed them in their land. And when the war ended, the whole refugees from Iran came their land, Afghanistan. But unfortunately, there was 30 lakh refugees of Afghanistan entered Pakistan, and they made their identity card, passport, and they got their own nationality of Pakistan. So still they are in Pakistan. So after that, a turning point started when Taliban came or they built government almost in 95% area of Afghanistan. So then USA, there the 11 September 2001, there was the turning point when 9/11 incident took place, and USA then attacked on Taliban, and they started in invasion and attacking and bombarding on the Taliban. Then there was a Bonn Agreement. This was the turning point. Bonn Agreement in 5 December 2001. Bonn Agreement happened here, and through this Bonn Agreement, Hamid Karzai was chosen as the president of Afghanistan. Then the election, first general election of the history of Afghanistan happened in 2004. So in 2004, first general election, Hamid Karzai was also became a president of Afghanistan in that time. So this happened. First of all, there was Bonn Agreement that happened 5 December 2001, and then their first general election 2004, Hamid Karzai came again as a president. So there was also a question that how many there are, what is the biggest group in Afghanistan? So basically, Pashtun, this is the biggest group in Afghanistan. They are almost 42%.
Second, they are group of Tajik tribe. They are almost 27%. And then there is another group like Hazara. So they are almost 9%. So these are three biggest group. First, majority of the population consists here on Pashtun. They are 42%. So in the same way, Jirga, there is Grand Assembly, there is which name is Loya Jirga. The member of Loya Jirga are 502, and the assembly of Afghanistan consists upon two houses, upper house, lower house. Upper house mean house of elder, upper house name house of elder, and lower house name house of the people. And upper house, i.e. house of elder, it has 102 member, and lower house, i.e. house of the people, it consists on the member of 250. So the strategical position of the region is this, that there is in the backward time, in Paleolithic age, in Stone Age, there was Silk Route which connects East Asia to the Central Asia, then Iran, then other countries. So this became a crossroad, and this became the buffer zone or neutral zone, which was anyone did not capture almost all the time. This was remained buffer state between British government at that time and between the USSR. So almost this became free when the whole region, there was the government of USSR, and in this region there was the government of British.